Hey everybody, this is Andy from Tennis Euphoria, and today I'm bringing you my review of the Tecnifibre TF40 305 16x19. So Tecnifibre are doing pretty well at the moment, aren't they? Loads of world number ones using their rackets right now. This TF40, I suppose the tech to shout about is the RS section. We still have Dynacore, now Extents in the layup. I think it's worth noting that foam is present. The previous TF40, both were good sticks at the 315 and the 305. They both had lovely touch and feel, good modern day player's sticks. I think the 305, everyone would agree, was the winner from the last batch, because even though it was lighter, it had loads more plow through compared to the underpowered 315. Lovely touch and feel. And of course, the previous iteration only came with 18 by 20 string patterns. Knowing that that 305 was the winner, I've elected to review the 305, but I've gone with the 16x19 because that sort of suits my game a little bit better, and also strongly suspect that it will be the 16x19 that's of most interest to everyone. So my first hit, you're immediately taken with the similarity to the previous version in terms of connectivity to your shots. Nice reliable string bed. It's got a really comfortable response. I think that foam filling shouldn't be underestimated. A foam filled racket with a 64 RA, I think, is a lovely sort of stable, relatively powerful but very comfortable setup. The target specs for this frame is the 64 flex 321 swing weight. We obviously have a 16x19 pattern. Mine was underweight, both of them were actually, at 300 grams. So they were coming in a little bit light on swing weight, which was disappointing overall, particularly as these are frames that I could certainly settle into. But it means I think that they can get even better with some customization. So one thing that is noticeable with the 16x19 string pattern is that you do get more lift, more insurance, certainly you get more spin, and within the first hit I was feeling sort of pretty comfortable with the frame, already enjoying it, I suppose. So doing some slinger drills, I tend to try and do these same drills with all rackets that I'll review. I like to hit backhands and just spray them around the court, go for different targets to assess directional control. Then I'll do the same with forehands. This did super well, certainly with sort of medium range balls, you could really hit your targets. Same on the forehand side, point and shoot in that respect. You certainly get more cut on the ball. Actually much prefer this 16x19 string pattern compared to the previous 18x20. I think you still have bags of directional control, but I think you can be actually a bit more aggressive with some angles, and I think you can hit out and actually do some more damage with some good spin. So already this would be my choice, the 16x19 pattern. I think with any players' frames, one key test is to look at how it handles short balls, how obviously movement is key in these movements, but how effective is the frame with putting away shorter balls. So I'll always try and set up the slinger for short balls and assess how I can hit different targets coming in on that ball, and this frame is just superb there. I quite quickly restrung with a favoured setup of mine that's worked particularly well in similar rackets. I'm thinking particularly of the Blade V8. So I restrung with Luxlon Alu Power at 52 pounds in the mains, and then I went with Slinko Vanquish in the crosses, again at 52 pounds. And that's a setup I'd landed at in the Blade, because despite the Blade's low RA and flex rating, I actually found that racket to be causing some elbow and shoulder soreness, and I was using it quite a lot. Actually with this TF40, I found that it plays much better with a full bed of poly. And I do find that to sometimes be the case with control orientated sticks, and that's something to bear in mind. Personally, I think that if you're going with sort of softer polys that do give some good snapback, then the whole notion of a hybrid in a control orientated racket is sometimes lost on the racket. And this is very much the case here. The winning string for me, in case it's of interest, was Razor Code. I tried Ice Code and Razor Code, and Razor Code, I think, is actually an absolutely fantastic string. Durability, I'd say, is only kind of medium, but particularly if you've got access to a stringing machine, the playability is awesome, particularly with this racket. And it's also got all of those sort of positive playability aspects with some nice comfort. So one thing that's pretty obvious, I guess, with this sort of frame, the last was excellent on slice. I personally don't think you lose anything with the 16x19 either. You can still knife a slice, and it didn't take me long to start to dial that in, and I thought that it would definitely carry over really well to match play. So the next hit that I had with it was in a really windy day and a really hot day, but the wind was so bad that I actually thought this would be a good test for sweet spot, and it passed with flying colours. So I think the sweet spot is actually relatively generous, and I think the shape of the racket is quite interesting. I think this feels like a bit of a blended Pure Strike Project 1-7 combined with the previous 1820, and both of those were you know, fantastic sticks. One thing that I was really taken by was serve. You know, here just warming up my serve, you get great directional control, and I actually think the positives of a foam filled racket is that you've got really good stability, and that carried through to some good serve power for me. I was getting more power and more kick from the TF40 than I was compared to competitors, certainly that blade V8. And it makes me play how I want to play. You've got total confidence in hitting your targets. So just hitting serve, 1-2s, being aggressive, it's the perfect stick in my mind for that type of play. I think the other thing that I loved about the TF40's playability is its versatility. So I'd by this point had started to customize it up a little bit, added a leather grip, and I'd started to add just a little bit of weight at 10 and 2 just to bring it up more to its sort of stock target specs, and it was greatly improved. And I think the big thing for me is just I thoroughly enjoy playing with this stick, because you do end up with it feeling like an extension to your arm. You have confidence in it, and you also just feel encouraged to play really creatively. I find that if I'm playing with this TF40, I can play in any which way that I want to. So I can try and serve big and then just be aggressive on a second shot, try and put away points early. I can defend really well, because actually I've got plenty of kick and a good launch, good cut down in baseline shots. I can also knife a slice, and it's super stable on volleys. And then when I really want to as well, I can try crazy angles, play drop shots, hit with slice, approach with slice. I just think this is all round a great stick, and certainly this is for me a switchable stick that I will switch to. The only downside, I suppose, would be that quality control. To have two that came in under spec by 5 grams on weight and low on the swing weight was a little bit disappointing. I'll obviously customize them up, but it leaves me with a little bit of disappointment there, because typically when I've bought and tested Tecnifibre sticks before, I think I've probably been lucky based on comments that I've had in the past, but I've had good quality control. So that leaves me with a little bit of concern and worry. So in summary then, I think that this is well compared to the Project 1-7 Pure Strike, but with much better feel, more stability, you just feel much more connected to the ball, but you get all of the excellent directional control and aggressive positiveness that you used to get with that Project 1.7. Sometimes I'd find myself trying stupid things, but that was part of the fun of playing with this stick. It makes you try things and enjoy your tennis, and I think once you spend some time with it, you can actually end up being really effective with it. Hope that that's been useful. It's a keeper for me, as you can tell. Next up is another couple of white rackets for me. We're going to have a look at the Eager, sticking with the Tecnifibre theme, and also going to look at the Slinko Whiteout. So if that's of interest, subscribe to the channel. Thanks as ever for watching. Really appreciate likes and subscribes to help me do some more of this, because I quite enjoy it, but it's a bit of a labour of love. I'm certainly not doing it for any monetary return. I've got some ideas as to what I hope I can do with the following in the future, and ultimately help people find good rackets, but at the moment, as I say, it's a bit of a labour of love, and I appreciate all the support. See you in the next one.